Well, hi, hello, my dear students. Welcome to my video lecture class. Right, up to now, I uploaded video lectures on the topic friction. In this topic friction, I already uploaded video lectures, nearly 10 lectures I uploaded on the topic friction. Please go through the previous lectures for better understanding. Today, I am going to discuss the most important application based upon friction, application number 12. Please watch the lecture till the end. Definitely you'll get clear idea about this session. Right, application number 12. So what is application number 12 here? Let us consider a body of mass m which is sliding down from the rest from the rest, that means initial velocity is zero, from the rest on L by N portion of smooth inclined plane, on smooth and rough inclined plane, half planes of length L by N and L minus L by N respectively. Here the body finally comes to rest. Find coefficient of friction. This is a given question. How can we explain this question? First, note down this. So this is given question. I need some space. That's why I wrote this one. So here, okay. So this is a inclined plane of angle theta. Here is one body. Here initial velocity is equal to zero. Up to this portion, okay, and here, this portion is L minus L by nth portion. Okay, total length is L. and this portion is a rough portion, rough surface. It's a rough surface. This is smooth surface. Smooth surface. Here block. Here is the block. Here is the position of block. Here final velocity is 0. For this block, final velocity is 0. Final velocity is 0 for this block. Final velocity is 0. This is smooth, smooth surface, and here is rough surface. Here smooth, and this is a rough surface. Okay, this portion is a rough surface, and this portion is a smooth surface. Okay, case one. Case one. Case 1, for smooth inclined plane, for smooth inclined plane, initial velocity is equal to 0. Here this is our final velocity is V1, final velocity is V1, and acceleration A is equal to g sine theta, because it is down the inclined plane. A is equal to g sine theta. This we consider as A1 is equal to g sine theta. We consider, right? For this one, V square minus U square is equal to 2As. V square means V1 square. Okay. So this is u1 square 2a1 into s1. Here s1 is equal to l by n. V square means v square means v only, v1 square. U1 square means 0 square. 2 into a1 means g sine theta. s1 means l by n. Right, for this one, V square is equal to 2g sine theta into L by N. Case 2, for rough inclined plane. For rough inclined plane, U2 is equal to V1. If you consider this is V1. Okay. So then this is also V1. If you consider this is V1, so then what we got here, this is also V1, this is V1, this is also V1, this is also V1. So now U2 is equal to V1, V2 is equal to 0, A2 is equal to rough surface, this is rough inclined plate, is equal to g into sine theta minus mu k cos theta. Sine theta minus mu k cos theta. And S2 is equal to L minus L by N. S2 is equal to L minus L by N. This is. So apply here. V2 square minus U2 square is equal to 2a2s2. For this one, v2 square means 0 square. U2 square means v1 square is equal to 2 into a2 means g into sine theta minus mu k cos theta. Okay, minus mu k cos theta into s2. S2 is L into 1 minus 1 by N.
L into 1 minus 1 by M. So this value we got. This value we got. So from this, okay, so from this, minus V1 square is equal to, two into G into sin theta minus mu k cos theta L into 1 minus 1 by N. Okay, so from this, minus V1 square means already you know, 2G sin theta into L by N. Minus V1 square means minus 2G sin theta into L by N. Okay, L by N. Okay, so for this one, 2G sin theta minus mu k cos theta. Okay, here L by N into N minus 1. L by N into N minus 1. Here, 2G, L by N going to be cancelled. L by N going to be cancelled. For this one, what we got here? Minus sin theta is equal to G into sin theta minus mu k cos theta into N minus 1. Here, G sin theta N into G sin theta first of all write minus sin theta G into sin theta minus mu k G into cos theta into N minus 1. So multiply minus sin theta first G into N into sin theta minus mu k into G into N into cos theta finally minus G sin theta plus mu k into G into cos theta so from this, so here sin theta finally from this data, so we got mu is equal to tan theta into N by N minus 1. So here in this small change, need not to write these all the things. Divide both sides with sin theta minus sin theta by sin theta minus sin theta by sin theta G sin theta by sin theta minus mu k into G cos theta by sin theta
n minus 1.
Okay. We are taking n minus 1. From this. Finally, what we got? Minus 1 is equal to g into g minus mu k into mu k into mu k into g into mu k into g into cot theta into n minus 1. So from this, tan theta is equal to tan theta into n by n minus 1, n by n minus 1, tan theta into n by n minus 1, n by n minus 1 is equal to mu. Coefficient of kinetic friction, mu k. Coefficient of kinetic friction, mu k is equal to tan theta into n by n minus 1. n by n minus 1. So, this is about today's session. I hope you are all understood this lecture. If you will get any doubt, please feel free to mention in comment box. So, I hope you are all are watching my videos. Thank you for watching my videos. Thank you for encouraging me. Thank you so much.